Welcome to a video of the new features of TMS WEB Core version 1.3 Ferrara. TMS WEB Core, that's the radical web from TMS. Even though it is just a subversion number, version 1.3, Ferrara has many improvements that will make your life much easier working with TMS WEB Core, so do not hesitate to upgrade if you already have a license, and maybe these features will trigger your interest to invest in building your future web applications with TMS WEB Core. First of all, two parameters called obfuscation and optimization are available for your release configurations now. The obfuscation parameter makes sure that the source code that is generated by the Pascal to JavaScript transpiler is not as readable. That means variable names are being changed, spaces are removed, line feeds are removed. And the optimization parameter makes sure that only Pascal source code that is actually used is being transferred into JavaScript. Of course, even though the obfuscation parameter makes it tough to read your source code, you still should not put any confidential information into your JavaScript source code because it is still readable. Your TMS web applications so far lacked any versioning information like a desktop EXE. Now with WEB Core 1.3, you can add a version and you can also tell the IDE to automatically increment the version number for every release built. With TMS WEB Core, you have many means to design your forms. One of them is to completely build HTML design and then link your controls that you defined in the Delphi Form Designer to these HTML controls. This is done using the ID tag. However, it sometimes is clumsy as you forget what you named your ID tags or the list is rather long. So this dialog makes your life rather easy. Control binding lists all the IDs in the associated HTML file, and then you have the option to link your controls to these HTML ID elements. The dialog also takes care of the fact that you do not use the same ID tag for multiple controls. One of the most requested features is form inheritance. Now with version 1.3, you can inherit your forms. Simply right-click on the form in the project manager and you have the option to derive from that form. The IDE automatically creates a new form that is inherited of that form and it also inherits all the design elements. Very close to form inheritance is frame support, probably just as much requested as form inheritance. Just like you're used from the VCL, you can use the frames component to put your frames that you built on another form. Whenever you build lists that are linked to data, you need some kind of HTML templates. These properties are usually just strings or string lists and make it tough to add design. That's why TMS added a designer so that you can use a toolbar and a preview window to add design to your properties. With regard to data access, TMS added Firestore support via TWebFirestoreClientDataset. That means you have a client dataset to access Firestore databases on the web. The same applies to myCloudData. For that, you have TWebMyCloudDBClientDataset. In the Lazarus world, there was a product called SQLRestDBBridge. The product allows you to send SQL requests to a database, and the results are being sent back as JSON, kind of like a web service. However, the key here is you can use this with existing databases. You send SQL statements to a database, and the result is being sent back to your web application. The SQLRestDBBridge makes it easy for you to send SQL requests to existing databases and get back the results as JSON. Furthermore, as it's a dataset, you can directly access the result using your dataset. The feature that required possibly the biggest development time is push notifications. TMS WEB Core has been expanded with components for the front-end and back-end that allow you to build applications with push notifications. As it's shown here in the pictures, the push notifications work both with desktop browsers and mobile browsers. Cryptography is very important and should not be missing from TMS WEB Core. Now with version 1.3, the most common encryption classes are available to use as Pascal classes. Catching up with Delphi here on the desktop side, regular expressions have been added to the language of TMS Web Core. It pretty much matches the class TRegEx that has recently been added to Delphi. So if you can use the TRegEx class in your VCL applications, you sure can use TRegEx class in TMS Web Core. Uploading local data to your web applications is very important, but sadly has been a little bit tricky in the past. Now with the new version, you can access single or multi-file, access a list of files, and you can get the file content as text, you can get the URL, a binary array, or a base64 string, and that is all done using the components TWebFilePicker and TWebFileUpload. Everything has gotten a lot easier. Two UI controls that have been missing so far and are rather common in the VCL. So now you also have a lookup combo box and a DB variant of a lookup combo box for TMS Web Core. Sadly missed before, now there is a TWebMain menu that works without any link to jQuery. You have built-in hamburger menu support and their design is responsive, meaning on a mobile device you get the common three horizontal lines for the menu, or on a desktop everything collapses and expands. My favorite feature of them all, TWebGoogle Maps, has finally caught up with the desktop variant. You can add polygons, polylines, rectangles, and circles. You can add waypoints to routes. You can use KML layers and theme support. And another big feature, you can load your tracking data from GPX files and draw them on the map. Another handy feature if you want to display lots of images, thumbnail first, want to give your user the ability to click on the thumbnail and show it as full screen, that is exactly what TWeb Image Zoom Control does. You get a tiny little thumbnail, and if you click on the image, it is zoomed and you can see it in full screen. TMS Web Core recently added Electron support so that you can build multi-platform, means Windows, Linux, and macOS, desktop applications. And even though it sounds strange at first, building web applications that are run on the desktop, but Electron makes that all possible. However, there's some difficulty now because Electron has multiple versions, so you want to be able to support the newest features. In order to make your applications compatible, TMS introduced the Electron 6 Up compiler directive so you can include specific features for Electron 6 and up. Of course, the PaaS2.js compiler has been upgraded to the latest version and all the latest RTL functions have also been added. Another major haul for the demonstrations. All new features have demos now, and especially to mention our 5 backend-based demos, meaning backend like database plus client, and there have many demos been added for Lazarus. For the insiders that built their own TMS Web Core classes already, you now have a custom attribute that you can define that will automatically include a certain CSS library into your HTML. So this will also happen for the TMS Web Core components. As soon as you drop them on the form, we will make sure that the associated CSS framework is also being added, as well as the JavaScript framework. So let's say you add a Bootstrap specific component, you can be certain that Bootstrap will be included in your application. You no longer have to manually add anything using the IDE. And as always, numerous smaller, bigger improvements and fixes to improve your quality to make your daily work with TMS Web Core much easier. Hopefully we triggered your interest. I mean, these were 22 features that have been added to version 1.3. If you want more information on a specific feature, go to webtmssoftware.com. There's demonstration for most of these features. There's a user manual. And of course, if you're already a user, you can download your version there. There's also a trial if I triggered your interest maybe to develop a web application with TMS Web Core.